Okay, I'm starting part B of the stoichiometry lab for Chem 121. Now look over on the upper right side. You can see the claim on the label, sodium bicarbonate, 1916 milligrams. That is the claim of how much baking soda is in this set of Alka-Seltzer tablets. Oh, it's not so easy to read. Let me turn the light on. If you can see it better. Okay, here we are. So we have two tablets and that is the total claim on there. Now I'm going to, here we just have to tear our balance, put the watch glass on it, and then put our tablet of Alka-Seltzer on it. For trial one, that is 58.9. 58.9 grams. All right, here is our, oh no, that's, where's our beaker? Here we go. Dry this off for trial two. Sorry, this isn't trial two. This is part B, analysis of an antacid. And I've measured out my 50 mils of acid already. Okay. Good, that still reads the same. There's my 50 milliliters of acetic acid. And I have to weigh these separately, as I mentioned before. 159.7. Beaker with the acid before, 159.7 grams. Okay, now I'm gonna take that off and I'm gonna drop that in there and let it fizz away. Oh, you can barely see it. All right, I have this other balance here, but it has no decimal places, so it didn't really work as well as my tiny balance. Okay, I'm gonna weigh the glass after. So the mass of the watch glass by itself is 55.6 grams. And we're gonna accept that for both trial one and two. 55.6 grams is the glass by itself. Okay, I will add tablet number two. So I'm starting trial two right now while I wait for trial one to finish up, and that might take a little bit of time. Ahead and measure out my 50 mils of acid. And it doesn't have to be perfect, although that pretty much is. Oh, this mass is 58.9 grams for the watch glass and tablet number two together. All right, now's the waiting part. I guess I don't need that bit anymore. Now that tablet has some other stuff in it. It's not pure sodium bicarbonate. It's got some binding agents in it. And so it's not all gonna dissolve. There might be a little bit left. But again, we wanna wait. We wanna wait until the reaction is over before we weigh it. So how will we know the reaction is over? Did I record? Yes, okay. Thing because I only have one pack of Alka-Seltzer. So let's take a look at that up close. Definitely still reacting. But it's starting to clear up a little. You can see a little bit of solid material moving around in there, I think. That would be maybe the binding agents, or some antacid tablets have aspirin or other compounds in it that might not dissolve completely. All right, it's slowing down. I'm gonna give it another little swirl just to make sure. And I do see some solid in there. Maybe I'll show you that. I think the black background is helpful. So let me just show you what it looks like. Hold on, I can, of course I have to turn on to zero first. All right, and then I'll put the beaker on. So you can see all that solid stuff that didn't dissolve. And there's our mass, 161.9. Beaker after, 161.9 grams. Okay. So bear with me a moment while I wash the beaker out and give it a good dry. Dry it out. And then I'm going to add my acid to it. Oh, I'm a little bit zoomed in there. There we go. All right, put my acid in the beaker. Now I'm going to weigh it. 159.5 grams. The beaker with acid before reaction. Now I'll drop that in. And we just wait for it to react. Here we go, now we can see what we're looking at. So let me talk, while this is reacting, let me talk a moment about how part A and B are different. In part A, we were trying to determine what governs this reaction. So we had three reactions on page 67 that I have here. Show that right there. Okay. We have three reactions, A, B, and C. And we're looking at how much sodium bicarbonate is produced or used, how much sodium bicarbonate is used compared to how much CO2 is produced. So what we're really looking at are those numbers in front, the mole-mole ratios, the relationship. So one bicarbonate could produce two carbon dioxides, or one bicarbonate could produce one carbon dioxide, or two sodium bicarbonate could produce one carbon dioxide. So we're going to compare those ratios, the 1:2, 1:1, or 2:1 relationships to figure out which reaction is the one that governs this process. So in part A, we're going to calculate, right, we know moles that we put in and it's all used up, and we're going to calculate moles produced, and we're going to compare those. So in part A, we're going to pick a reaction. Now in part B, we're going to use that reaction to determine how much sodium bicarbonate was in the tablet. So how much must have been there? that looking? Let's take a look in the camera. Still going. All right, now in part B, you're gonna pick a reaction. So one of these is gonna tell you, you are going to find how many moles of CO2 are produced, and from that value, you're gonna figure out how many grams of sodium bicarbonate must have been in that tablet. So the calculation goes a different way. And let me just illustrate this on here. So you see visually on the data tables what you're doing. This is part A. So we use 2.3 grams here of sodium bicarbonate, and that's the value. You're gonna use that. Remember, it all got used up. So you're gonna use that to calculate how many moles of bicarbonate got used up, and then you're gonna compare it to this one, E and F. Compare these values to figure out which reaction is correct. Notice that we do have this correction value, this point, here it is, 0.004 moles. That may have been updated. I don't remember the correct value now. That represents all the CO2 that stayed in the water. So some of that gas doesn't boil out. Some of it is just can dissolve in 50 milliliters of aqueous solution. You can see some solids hanging in there. And let me give this another stir and then we'll weigh it. Okay, that mass is 161.9. Wow, we nailed it. Okay, so back to the calculations. When we do part B, where we're gonna use what we learned in part A to figure out how much of this is really there. So we know that the label claims 1.619 grams of sodium bicarbonate. And now you're gonna take all this data and you're gonna figure out how many moles of CO2 were produced. So you're measuring that and then you're gonna calculate that correction. Right, so this thing, that starred one includes the correction. And then based on your relationship in the equation, you'll use that chemical equation to calculate from this to this. So knowing the relationship between the CO2 and the sodium bicarbonate, use that mole-mole relationship to calculate moles of sodium bicarbonate from moles of CO2. Then you're gonna go from moles to mass. So you're gonna calculate from your own results how many grams of sodium bicarbonate must have been in that tablet for trial one and trial two. And then we're gonna compare it to that number up there, which I may have said something wrong at the beginning. That is per tablet. Okay, now I'm not quite remembering. See, it says fully dissolved two tablets. Each tablet contains 1916 milligrams. Okay, so it is each tablet. So we'll compare those two mass, those two values. Okay, I can't really see. We're gonna compare those two values for the mass from part B to 1.916 grams. And that's what we'll be using as our claimed value. We're gonna figure out how accurate is that claim. All right, it's pretty cool when you think about it. So think about your purpose. The purpose was to verify the claim on the label by experimentation. Okay, good job.